that they know you, the only true God, and Jesus Christ whom you have sent. This is eternal life. There is no eternal life outside of Christ. You have not trusting in Jesus Christ? No, you're perishing in your sins, friend. You can trust upon Christ while God has given you time. You can laugh now, but you won't be laughing in hell. You see, here's the thing. This might come as a surprise, but God doesn't need you, young man. You need God. You need God for forgiveness. While he's given you time. If God struck you guys dead tonight, you wouldn't lose anything. You need his forgiveness. And that's the good news, that God can save you. And that's the great news, that God saves sinners. He saves sinners like me, like Robert, like Michael, like God. He saves sinners because King Jesus, he is King. And he is Lord, he is Savior. He is an infinitely holy Son of God. The King of Israel, the King of the Jews. Yes, he is King of the Jews. No Jew will enter heaven outside of Jesus Christ, Yeshua, HaMashiach. There's no way into heaven apart from the Lord Jesus Christ. He is the Lord of glory, the King of glory, the great I am, who is, who was, and who is to come. He is the only hope for anyone. No salvation without Jesus Christ and him alone. Are you guys ready to repent? God commands all people everywhere to repent, to forsake your sin and turn to Jesus Christ. You must repent towards God and believe upon his Son, Jesus Christ. Your Creator offers you salvation, and now is the time of salvation. Tomorrow is not promised. Tomorrow is not promised for no soul. You must come to God. Come to God now while he's giving you time. For great is the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Great is the name of God, our Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Cry out to God while he's giving you time. Seek the goodness of God through his Son, Jesus Christ. Amen.
My God.
yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle, lowly in heart, and you will find rest for your souls. My yoke is easy. My burden is light, Jesus said. This is good news. It's not about going to church. It's not about doing religious activity. It's what Jesus did on the cross. It's all about Jesus. Jesus is my magnificent obsession. I love Jesus. He died on the cross for my sins, so my sins would be forgiven. Good news, my friend. Your sins can be forgiven today. Are your sins forgiven? You can have the power over death through Jesus Christ. Good news. God so loved the world, he gave his only begotten Son. Whoever believes should not perish, but have everlasting life. You see, God did not send his Son in the world to condemn the world, but the world through him might be saved. He that believes in the Son is not condemned. He believes in the Son not is condemned already. You see, you are condemned already because of your sins that separated you from God. See, the Bible says we love the dark and hate the light. We love getting intoxicated. We love having premarital sex. We love people smoking marijuana. We love this because we love the dark and hate the light, and we're in bondage of sin. But Jesus came to set the captive free. He came to set you free. My friends, call on Jesus today. Come now, let us reason, says the Lord. Though your sins are like scarlet, they shall be white as snow. Though they are red like crimson, they shall be as wool. Your sins can be forgiven today. Repent and put your trust in Jesus Christ today. The Bible says now is the day of salvation. You see, the Bible says he that sinneth is of the devil. But the devil sinned from the beginning. This reason the Son of God was manifested, that he may destroy the works of the devil. As you sin, you're a slave to sin. You're a slave to premarital sex, getting drunk, getting intoxicated. But praise the Lord, Jesus. He can set you free from your sin through Jesus Christ. Call on him today, my friend. We got brothers in Christ here who'd love to talk to you. We got free material. We have a free Bible. We can help you out. Get into the Word of God today. Call on Jesus Christ. If anyone be in Christ, he's a new creature. All things pass. All things become new, my friend. Bible says, enter through the narrow gate. For wide is the gate, broad is the road that leads to destruction. And many will enter in by it. Because narrow is the gate, difficult is the way that leads to life. Very few will ever find eternal life. Because you love your sin more than you love God. You know, when I came to this country, I changed my American currency for English currency. And what I found out is on your 10-pound bill, there's a picture of a man on there, on the 10-pound bill, and his name is Charles Darwin. Do you know who Charles Darwin is? And the sad thing is, Charles Darwin, evolution is a fairy tale. You see, it would only be fair, if you have Charles Darwin, you should have Mickey Mouse on your 10-pound bill. You should have Donald Duck on your 10-pound bill. Because evolution is the biggest fairy tale ever told. And Charles Darwin is your guru. He's your master. You see? And this is the problem, is that you need to know that there's a God. The God of the universe is watching you. To believe in fairy tales, that all we are is premortal slime that evolved to a higher order, that we have no dignity. From food to the zoo to you is a fairy tale. From a frog to a prince is a fairy tale. You believe in fairy tales. So I'm out here to open your eyes today to the truth. The truth is that you, Lord, in the beginning laid the foundations of the earth. The heavens are the work of your hands. God created all. No matter how much you suppress the truth, there is no God. That God you will stand before and give account of your life. Every word, every deed, every thought will be shown before the righteous judge of the universe. The Bible says that you, he'll make you as a blazing oven at the time of his anger. The Lord will swallow you up with his wrath, and the fire will devour.
the day. Because God has to deal with sin. He has to deal with sin. Sir, are your sins forgiven? Are your sins forgiven? Well, sir, on Judgment Day, you're going to be in big trouble before God. You better call on Jesus right now. Turn your life. Because time is short. Ma'am, are your sins forgiven? You know, many of you may mock, but the statistics are 150,000 people die every day. So this message is very important. And I come out here because the Bible tells me to love your neighbor. And if you have the best interest for your neighbor, you'll tell them the truth. And the truth is that Jesus said, I am the way, I am the truth, I am the life. No one will come to the Father except through Jesus Christ. There's only one way, my friends, nor is there salvation in any other. There's no name under heaven given amongst men except through Jesus Christ. There's only one mediator between man and God, and that is Christ Jesus, the man. So my friend, Jesus clearly said, most surely I say to you, he who does not enter the sheephole by the door, but climbs over some other way, is no better than a thief and a robber. Jesus said, I am the door. He that enters through me will be saved. This is good news, my friend. Good news today. You're hearing good news in Wales today. In Swansea, Wales, you're hearing good news. God has sent preachers out into Swansea, Wales to tell you good news. That your sins can be forgiven today. But the problem is many of you love your sin. You love your sin more than you love the God of the universe. Because you're a slave to sin. You're an enemy of God. The Bible says from within the heart of men proceed evil thoughts. Adultery, fornication, theft, covetousness, wickedness, deceit, lewdness, an evil eye, blasphemy, pride, foolishness. All these things come from within and defile a man. You see, the heart is wicked. The Bible says the heart is wicked and it's deceitful. Who can know it? Who can trust it? You need to get a heart transplant. You need to cry out to God and beg and plead Him that it gives you a new heart. So you have new desires. So you'll love God with your heart, soul, and mind. Call on Jesus Christ today. Because Jesus said there'll be weeping, wailing, gnashing of teeth, eternal torment. Yes, sir, on that day you stand before God. Everything you've done in the dark will